are very charismatic creatures. They work hard to build really big, amazing dams. They live in family structures. I don't know how anyone could not love someone with orange teeth.
This area probably had beavers in the past, but what we see here is a lot of erosion and downcutting of the stream. You can see the floodplain is way up there, about 30 feet up above, and the stream's just eroded and downcut. And so our hope is to release beavers, and they'll build these dams, which will catch sediment and raise that stream and hopefully connect the floodplain again. And our hope is to be able to release fish by having these ponds. It provides habitat for fish and amphibian species.
Something not everyone knows about beavers is that they have really positive impacts on stream ecosystems. They do everything from create habitat for wildlife and fish to creating fire breaks on the landscape. So that's why our team and volunteers and partners are working hard to build these what are called beaver dam analogs, which are restoration structures that work to mimic the amazing impacts of beavers. So what we're trying to do is heal the habitat enough so that we can reintroduce beavers in some of these places and they can continue the work of our volunteers.
Exciting to release the beavers because we're giving them a chance to kind of take over the work that is done by these human-made beaver dam analogs, and we know that they can get established and just start kind of spreading and changing the habitat over time.
We're building a dam. We're gonna make a little pool for them to hide into. It's been found that just releasing beavers without building a preparatory dam or a man-made dam for them to have cover in is, you know, it's more effective to do that so they have protection from predators.
I'm really excited to be here because it's my first time seeing beavers released after building BDAs.
Incredible to watch them walk out across the habitat. We just wish them well as they go out and start their amazing beaver work.